My name is Sahani Amarasekara. I graduated from Branksome in 2006. I am currently a physician and in my last year of training to be an ophthalmologist at the University of Pittsburgh, where I serve as chief resident. I was always familiar with a career in medicine because both of my parents are physicians, but the roles that a physician can play in the community, not just their local community, but also internationally, was not something that I necessarily was exposed to until high school and university. I chose ophthalmology for a lot of different reasons. Firstly, it combines medicine and surgery in a way that very few specialties are able to. I also thought it would be a great way to incorporate my interest in public health. After my first year of university, I spent time with an organization called Unite for Sight. And basically what they do is they go to developing countries and provide vision care to communities that otherwise wouldn't have access. My family is originally from Sri Lanka, so that made me start to think about what types of barriers to care are there in Sri Lanka and what types of needs were underserved. And I found that there was a really large diabetic population in Sri Lanka that just wasn't getting the routine access to vision care that you would want them to get if they were living here in North America. So I worked with a few different doctors there and the Government of Health, and we started a screening program for diabetics in Sri Lanka.
So I nominated my sister because she's definitely the most hardworking person I know. She's always looking to do something new and kind of never satisfied with where she's at. Although she's a really accomplished person, she's just always pursuing new activities and looking to help out others and looking to find new ways to improve herself and her skills, and I think that that's just a really admirable quality.
I think my favorite subject at Branksome was probably history. I did IB history higher level with Ms. Marshall, and she really forced us to think critically about some of these topics that, you know, with history there are times when things could be a little bit more straightforward or a little bit more dry, but she found a way to make it exciting and made us really engage with the material.
I can remember to this day her research investigation wherein she looked at the revolution in Cuba. She ordered online, long before Amazon was in operation, the latest, most up-to-date historical publication on the topic of the revolution. So she was always thorough, curious, and really willing to go that extra mile.
While I do remember her clear ambition, her strong desire to do well academically, her meticulousness with her work, I really do also remember her kindness, her gentleness, her compassion, and just what a nice person Sohani was.
I was close to some of the girls who were in boarding. Being able to learn from them, I went on exchange to Australia. While I was there, I got to travel a bit with Model United Nations and debating. Now I have the confidence to take on leadership roles or travel by myself. I'm not as afraid just because I've been doing that for so long now. If I had a message for girls at Branksome, it would be to absolutely take every opportunity that life gives you. You never know where it's going to lead you. And I think it's really important to have role models and a support system so that someone can help sort of model or pave the way for you, especially in science and technology, and creating that community and also setting a path for girls to come after you. Thank you so much to my teachers, my friends, and my mentors at Branksome for helping and all the support that they've given me. I absolutely adore the Branksome community, so I'm very honored and very flattered.